I'm going to construct a mitered corner on this curtain. Firstly, we'll start by turning the hem 6 inches. Find the bottom line in there, hold it back, and fold up to the line, giving yourself a double 3-inch hem. Fold back over. You now have a 3-inch hem folded. Don't iron across here, because this will cause a ridge at the front of the curtain. Open the curtain out again and fold in the side turn-ins. They need to be folded in by 2 inches. Iron them in, open out the curtain again. You now have a 2-inch side turn, a 6-inch turn, and a 3-inch turn, all clearly visible by the crease lines you've just put in. You need a pin for this. Get a pin, come down your 2-inch line to where it meets the 6-inch. Place the pin in the corner there, taking the bottom of the 2-inch side turn, bring it up to the top 6-inch hem turning, using your pin to keep the fabric straight at the same time. Take the pin out and just fold across there. What you'll find is this 2-inch hem now runs across the 6-inch hem. Iron in. Remove the bulk before folding in. I'm taking off here 1¼ inch. I'm leaving, 1¼ inch of fabric within the mitre. Now, if you're making your curtains properly, you would herringbone that into place there. Okay, fold back up your 3-inch. Finger crease the line back into place, and then fold up your 6-inch. Again, finger crease the line into place. Coming from the side, fold the side turnings back in as well, ensuring that everything is nice and straight as it was before. You now have a perfect mitered corner. In order to finish this, place your weight inside, stitch that in, and then ladder stitch the mitre closed. Herringbone stitch down the side of your 2-inch turn and slip stitch across your hem. Just put that to one side and I'll show you how to lay in the lining. This one is already stitched. Just quickly to show you how to lay in the linings of the curtain. When you're making the linings, use a 2-inch, double 2-inch hem, 4 inches, fold into 2 inches, giving you a smaller hem, like so. Lay on top of your curtain. Fold back the hem of the lining and level it to the hem, like so. This helps in getting the linings in straight. Don't worry about overlapping at the side, we're going to cut that off. Because you've got a 2-inch lining and a 3-inch hem on your curtain, you now have a nice line at the bottom here, telling me that the lining is in straight with the curtain. Go to the side of your curtain now to straighten out your lining. Turn your lining back, level with your 2-inch hem. Put your ruler or grid board onto the lining and measure in 2 inches. And cut the excess away. Keep this nice and level and nice and neat with your cuts. Don't cut jagged edges, otherwise it will show through. Bring your curtain back down, your lining back down, and it's level with the curtain now. What we're going to do now, just cut that out of the way. Fold the lining under to bring it level with the mitre. So the corner of the lining becomes level with the mitre. You have a nice straight side down like so. Iron lightly, just so not to cause ridges at the front on the lining. Slip stitch from about 1 to 1.5 inches, from the bottom slip stitch round and all the way up to the top to your header tape. And then that's it.